And that's interesting because that experience is exactly what the scientific models have found in motivation, is that there's up to the point, so there's kind of controlled motivations and autonomous motivations. Mm-hmm. There's breakdowns in between those, but really those controlled motivations go up to that point of sort of when the social emotions like guilt and pride and things like that are involved, is that generally when you're motivated in that way, it tends to be negative. Now, there is a teeny slice on the controlled side that actually has neutral to slightly positive, and that's the, you know, like the positive side of interjects. So, but on the other side, the autonomous ones, it's like, that's where you it's all positive consequences. It's still extrinsic. That's the interesting thing, is that autonomous motivations are made up of two forms of extrinsic motivation and then intrinsic motivation. And those two forms are like the identified and the integrated. So what you're talking about is if you know why, that's that identified piece, is you can identify the positive possibilities here. You can understand why. You can justify it. Right. And that's the beginning of that really positive forms of motivation. It's like, okay, if I get it, then I go. And the other thing is that if your psychological needs are supported in that environment, you may upgrade your motivation to that integrated, like, oh yeah, okay, this is who I need to be in this situation. And that could develop into intrinsic motivation, but some things never get to that level of intrinsic motivation. Some things are just like, I do this because a person like me just does that, you know, whatever my identity is. That's the integrated piece. It's like, hey, that's just, it's not joyful, but it's like, hey, got to do it. And I'm cool with that.
And there's the reality of our life is there are all of those situations where, okay, here's how it should work, but I don't get to control what is, you know, the electric company doesn't care what I have to figure that out, you know. So being able to navigate that and understanding the difference, because I don't know that you always get that understanding of here's what I want, here's what is required of me to survive, and I have to be able to balance both of those,
right,
or at least navigate both of those, if it doesn't feel balanced all the time.
This is the Agentic Schools Vodcast, where you will learn about schools from around the world where children's agency to make decisions about their learning and living is more important than their academic skills. What makes education possible is the satisfaction of psychological needs. So that is what these schools have in common with all others. What makes a school agentic is satisfying those needs particularly well. I'm your host, Don Berg.